I am coming at you from my mom's room. It is a little bit too hot upstairs for me with this new AC here in Germany. But today I'm going to be doing full glam. I might go through, talk about like what I'm doing, but I will kind of speed it up throughout, and so it's not too long of a video for you guys. But I hope you guys enjoy. It's gonna be fun, and yeah, let's get started.
So first we're gonna shake this mess out. You already know what's happening. Yes, honey. Okay, and now we're gonna go in and part it like so, then obviously put into sections. I normally just put it into two sections and then part as I go, which you will see here in a few minutes. Then I'm gonna go in with my Amika blowout spray. Works as my heat protectant. I couldn't find anything else, but this is what I use. Ignore my face. Just spray it in like so. I try to get my ends for the most part, because that's what really needs protection for me. But here I go parting it. So I just take, obviously, a little section at the bottom, parting it. I use like the top of my ear to kind of measure it. And then just clip the rest of it up and go in and straighten.
Side note, this is my best friend when I straighten my hair. And you will see why.
First of all, ignore me putting my hair in my mouth. This is how I make sure I'm straightening, like, properly. I'm weird, I know. Anyways, so as you can see, that like kind of like flat iron brush that I have is my best friend. I got it at Sally's and I absolutely love it. It brushes my hair as I'm straightening it, basically similar to, you know, like the flat iron brushes or flat iron combs, I think they're called. So yeah, just like so. But I'm gonna go in and continue straightening, and yeah, I'm gonna speed this one up. Go on to the next side. Pause. It got super hot. You already know. All right. Let's get back to it. So I straightened my bangs going to the other side, so it kind of gives it a little bit of volume. My hair is kind of flat today, so ignore that. But yeah, you want to just zhuzh it up, as my mom would say. Kind of go underneath and give it some volume. And yeah, that's how I straighten my lovely hair.
So next I'm going to throw in some extensions. I have some clip-on extensions from Bellamy Hair. So I'll leave those in the description below. I'm sure everyone's heard of them. If you haven't, like I said, I'll be leaving the link in the description below. But yeah, here it goes.
To go in with just a little comb, I normally try and tease right at my roots, because something for the clips to grab onto if you do have thinner hair, this is actually very smart to do. Yeah. So So the first Swift has 4 clips on it. Length, honey. Okay, we got 22 inches today. 22. Okay. Yeah. Length. Yeah. It's happening. I'm a mess. All right. Let's put these in my hair. Okay, I'm not going to go through this whole entire thing. I'm going to also speed this process up a little bit. Like I said, you just want to part and separate the hair properly for each layer of clip-ons. When you're putting in your extensions, for me, I like to tease each layer that I do to kind of give the clips something to grab onto. And yeah, you just want to do that all the way through and try and blend it in as best as you can. But my hair is too short, so this is how it's looking. Don't judge. First thing I use is my You Better Work Gym Proof Primer from Essence. This is it. So I normally just like throw it onto my face, so don't judge me. I don't put this one on my eyes because if I do, my eyes start to water and it is honestly no fun. Sorry if you can't hear me either. It's freaking hot and I have this AC going. The next thing I use is the 111 Skin Harley St. London Rose Gold Radiance Booster. I don't know if you can see that. Obviously want to let that dry.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team fucking here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Nigga, started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole...
Okay. I don't know what that was, but here we go. The next thing is... I start with my foundation. I know a lot of people start with their eyeshadows or whatever, but I don't really use eyeshadows. It's not really my go-to thing. The only eyeshadow I have is ColourPop's Bare Necessities, and they have gorgeous colors in here. Don't mind the mess, but these are the beautiful colors, and you can tell which ones I only use. The other ones I really don't use that much because honestly, I'm not much of a risk taker when it comes to eyeshadows. I don't have the power or really the want to do it because I feel like I look like I have a black eye or just a bruise in general. Like, it's just not cute. But when I do it, I normally do like corner of my eyes. I do like a small like little like bronze color on my lid, but really other than that I don't really do much. Anyways,
So we're gonna get going into this foundation. I use Amazon Clay Tarte Foundation, full coverage. It is honestly my best friend. I am medium honey, 35H. Don't know if you can see that. Probably can't, but yeah, let's get going. You don't really need a lot. That's how much I use. And it works wonders. I really don't know what brush I have. This one. I'm not a makeup guru, people. I'm a fashion guru, okay?
So I just go in and take a little bit off of my hand and put onto the brush and just dab and blend onto my face, going from one side to the other. It's really not rocket science, but you know, some people have trouble, but it's okay. This is what I do though. Super pretty. Yeah. Okay.
And don't forget to blend out into your hairline, girls, because we know some of you ain't blending out there and you be looking like freaking Oompa Loompas, bad and cute, okay? Just stating facts, honey. Helping you out. Blend. Blend your makeup, please. I will go ahead and I guess I'll put some eyeshadow on. Even though I'm not really into it that much, but I'm gonna do it for you guys. Okay. I'm gonna take this brush. And I think we're going to go ahead and use this color right here. I lied
to you.
We'll put a base on first. I'll do a tease me first. This talk, this one, and I'll go back over. Designer Duds, this one, and put it on the corner of my eye.
I also went ahead and put it in the crease of my eye as well. And then for the second time, I went in with Its Talks to blend it all out and kind of give it more of a bronze look in the corner of my lid. But I hate using brushes, so I went in and used my finger. Then I went back in with a blending brush and blended it out. You already know. Next, I'm going to go in and do my eyebrows, fill them in. I couldn't find my eyebrow gel, so I just used what was ever left on the brush to fill them in, but I will try and leave the info for them in the description below. So next is eyeliner, and I use Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in black. And I put this gel pencil on my lower lid, and then I'll show you that I put liquid eyeliner on my top lid. So the next thing I use for my top lid is going to be the Manhattan Dip eyeliner. Sorry, I cannot talk today. I go in and use it on my top lids, and honestly, it's perfection. I love using this thing because it has the like precision tip on it, and it just gives me like the perfect wing. I also learned that if you measure from like going from the middle of your pupil out, then that will give you like the perfect wing for your eyeliner. So it just works out. So next I go in with my Essence Mascara Volume Stylist Lash Extension. I love this stuff. I feel like it actually like brushes through my lashes while I put it on. So it's really nice. I love it. After that, I go in with another mascara, the Manhattan Volume Shake Mascara. I just like to use another one to kind of give it a little bit more volume. You probably can't even tell, but I feel like I can. But yeah. Next, I'm going to go in with my angle brush and apply some blush. I believe this is the Catrice. I believe I'm saying that right. Blush. Obviously, my lid broke off, so we a little ghetto up in here, but it's okay. Next, we're gonna go in with another Catrice product and do some highlighting. Highlight that face. I also like to go underneath the brow and just give it a little highlight too. Obviously a girl needs her eyebrows waxed, but just ignore that. And for the last thing, I'm going to go in with Essence Color Boost Matte Lipstick. As you can tell, I love Essence products. They're good, cheap buy. But I feel like they get the job done, and for sometimes they work better than most expensive products, in my opinion. Essence is actually a vegan-free, cruelty-free, and, you know, I'm always for that, so. But anyways, I'm going to go in and do an outline on my lip. I'm going to do kind of an ombre look. I also learned this from the same place I learned about eyeliner. I don't know if you guys watched it, Glow Up. It's on Netflix and I adore it. But yeah, so we're just going to outline with a darker color and then we'll go in with a lighter. For the lighter color, I'm going to go in with MAC's Dazzle Gloss, I believe it's called. It's kind of like a lip gloss something for my... I'm actually going to put eyeshadow where I put the lip gloss at, kind of to give it more of a pop and some kind of like a little bit of shine to it. So like I said before, we're going to go back in with the ColourPop Bare Necessities for the lip. I'm going to put on the Talk for my lip as well, same shade as I did on my lid, and we're just gonna put it in the inner part of my lips, kind of to let it pop and give it some dimension and that ombre look. And the last thing I'm going to do is add this little head wrap to my hair, if I can get it situated correctly. I got it from Forever 21. It's super, super cute. It is like a silk material, so it does slide a little bit. I do recommend maybe adding some bobby pins to it if you're going to be wearing your hair up. But other than that, I love it. It's adorable, and you know me, I love my leopard and cheetah print. And that is the look, honeys. Yes. Serving looks.
I hope you guys enjoyed this lovely little glam video. It's my first one, so give it some love and subscribe, like, comment, you already know. And yeah, I think that's it. I will see you guys next week.